Alrighty, let's move on to the final stages of the blocking. At least we hope it's the final stages. Let's take a look at our mesh so far. The fur is roughly placed so that we can get a good read on how it feels in terms of its silhouette. So far it's looking really good. A few things I do want to add is maybe a few bits of fillers over there just to give it a bit more volume. Let's go back to my fantastic concept art here, drawn by an amazing artist. We've got some fur on for the brows. Okay, so we're going to add that, and then we'll do the fillers, and then I think that'll be enough for the blocking stages. For the brows, just thinking to myself, how do I want to approach this? Well, I can use fur cards, but because they're so numerous and very, very subtle, we're going to just use this bottom one right here. So I'm going to grab it. Let me use the center pivot. Let's go ahead and very roughly place it around this area as well. So I'm going to go somewhat like that. Okay. I'm going to delete some faces. Let me go ahead and adjust the eyebrow. There's somewhere around there. It's a bit like working on your belt. Very important that you keep in mind we have to match as closely as possible to the topology of the skull when it comes to the brows. That means we have to sort of match the number there. A reason being is because the brows are very deformable, okay? And having a mismatch on your polygon count, unless you have really, really high polys, is going to have some problems. It's really, really difficult to get right. So just go the safe route and match the number of polygons. Right now, we're not going to do that. We're only blocking things in. No big deal. But again, keep that in the back of your mind, okay? That will become more apparent as we go on through this course. So I'm going to go as close as possible, not too close. Just enough room for me to, work around it. I just need to be able to see what I'm doing. And we'll go back here. See the eyebrows, they move in this direction. Oop, a bit hard to see, so they move. Oh dear, nothing's working for me. Pink is always a good thing. All right, whatever, you guys kind of get the point. Just use white. So they move in this direction, like so. And they're also very short. So we don't want too much length here. I'm just going to make it somewhat like that. And here's another creative decision you want to think about. Do I want to add fronds like this? Do I want to add fronds like what we had before? Well, in the end of the day, it's kind of your call. I may have probably like a couple of fronds right here, but we're not going to follow something as at least the texturing method like here, like we have here. We might actually have transparent textures because they'll only be just singular, fur strands almost. Same deal up the top. We could add maybe a couple, like so, perhaps. But I guess we won't know until we start tightening things up. But for now, I think that's pretty good. I'm just going to leave those little extrusions there because this kind of brow will sort of taper off, okay, towards this distance, towards that distance. Let's grab this again. I'm going to delete some of the faces. And I'm going to add a small eyelash. Once again, this eyelash is going to match the topology of the eye because the eye is very deformable. But the plan is to sort of have the eye underneath, sorry, the eyebrows, eyelashes, sorry, underneath the eyelid somehow. We'll sort of tuck it in there in a way. And it will be, texture-wise, it will just be black. That will help us just get some good results, okay? And it will just help accentuate the eyes by itself. Think of it as toon lines. So again, just blocking things in. Very, very simple. Nothing too fancy about that. All right. The other thing is, of course, you can create eyelashes yourself. There are a number of reasons why I don't like to, you know, extrude individual strands from the actual mesh itself. It's because you don't have as much control over it. Again, it will become a bit more apparent later, but we'll stick with separate objects. That's the general rule of thumb here. If you're ever in doubt, use separate objects. It's the easiest and safest way to go. All right. In terms of fillers, we're going to fix this little segment up here just by adding a few more strands of polygons just to help us keep that this space full. Otherwise, it might feel a bit empty to the audience at certain angles anyway. It's looking pretty good. And over here, I might grab one of the back faces here, or the back topology. It is messy right now. That's okay. And then we'll, of course, just fix up the direction or the flow of that. Might even get rid of one or two of these edges here, because we don't really need it. Yeah, just clean it up. The lower the poly, the easier it is for you to control. This makes things so much easier for yourself. Great. Let's go and move this down here. So that feels less empty. We can probably add one more just to help us in certain rare angles. Like that. It might look a little bit out of place, so I'll add a third one and shrink it slightly. And then just rotate it so that we fill that up. So now that doesn't feel as empty as we had before. Okay. Of course you can change it. Change and adjust, you know, make it adjust the taste. So let's look at our silhouette so far. So it's looking better than what we had before. The hair is reading well. The silhouette of our character is looking fantastic. Oh, didn't want to miss that thing. That's very annoying. Okay, let's just have a quick look, see if we've missed anything. So we've got the ears, we've got the brows. So the brows we haven't duplicated across yet, so let's go ahead and do that. So change the pivot point to the center. I'm going to freeze the transformations and then mirror duplicate. Looks really, really good. Just for experimentation, I might create a small frond on this side, like that. Like so. Might even create an... Oops. Just create an off joint or off division. Like so, and then insert edge loop tool, go ahead and bend it around. Don't be afraid to bend things around, give it a little bit of pizzazz. I'm going to shrink that down. Of course we can, again, just bend it around, just give it a little bit of variety. Yeah. Looking great. Might even add a taper on the end. So let's go to Edge, Extrude, taper, like that. Who says eyebrows can't be interesting? Eyebrows can be really interesting. Such as, so strange, it's so funny. Hope you guys are having fun. I certainly am. Really, really enjoying how this is turning out right now. Quite pleased with it overall. I want to make a couple of adjustments to this side. I'm going to go to center pivot. And remember, I've mirrored it, so I want to select the vertices. That way it will change it on the opposite side. So just for that, I'm going to increase the size of that a little bit. Okay. Of course, same deal here. Let's make sure we get some good results. Fantastic. If you make any errors here, that's okay. You can just delete the left side and reduplicate and go from there. So we're doing all right so far. Let me create a black material just so that we can see those eyelashes here. So I'm going to just create Lambert. Pardon me. So select those two, Lambert. And change the material to black. Might do the same for the brows. Aside from looking a bit odd, at least I can see what it looks like. Alrighty. Looking fantastic. Very, very pleased with that so far. Even the silhouette's looking great. You can see there's this subtle thing. It just makes it read so well. Might have an issue over here. These fur cards are causing a few problems, so I want to make sure we make it a little bit readable. Might even duplicate it a little bit. That's not even complete, so I'm not too fussed at this stage. Well, that's fine. Something like that's okay. Okay, guys, I will see you in the next step.